Hey everyone, how's it going? Thanks for joining me for another episode of The Other Side of the Story with Tyler Calver, being broadcast from Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. For anyone that was watching last week, you would have saw we talked about social media and how a lot of people are getting canceled on social media. It's become a huge thing across the world, actually. People posting on social media, right away someone doesn't agree with what they're posting and they're getting canceled. In many cases, this isn't right because those posts are simply their own personal opinion. As long as it's not hate speech or anything that's negative, I don't know why people feel they have the right to cancel people. Which brings me to a topic that is really close and dear to my heart, which is cancel culture. And I want to talk about that, and I'm going to be talking with someone who's experienced that firsthand here in Cambridge, and he is one of the organizers of Neighborhood Watch Cambridge. His name is Adam Cooper, and we'll be talking with him in just a few minutes time. But first I want to talk about an important document that was created in 1948. It's called the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Yes, in 1948 we were talking about human rights, and this declaration focuses on 30 different articles, the basic human rights for everyone living in the world. One of the most important ones that I think is Article 19, and I'm going to read it for you. Article 19 states that everyone has the right to freedom of opinion and expression. This right includes freedom to hold opinions without interference and to seek, receive, and impart information and ideas through any media and regardless of frontiers. Think about that for a minute as you see the current cancel culture that we are experiencing across the world, and this declaration that was written in 1948. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Here in the city of Cambridge, Ontario, there is a group that was created on Facebook. It's called Neighborhood Watch Cambridge. And this group, just to give you a background, they started posting pictures and many people making comments on experiences that they had with crime, many of the people that live in the south end of the city. And this group has grown exponentially over the last few years. They now have 10,000 people on the group. And if you go on there, you can read the comments, you can see the pictures. They're very concerned about crime that is increasing in Cambridge. Of course, on Saturday night, there was a young man who was shot and killed in the south end of the city. So crime is a very important topic for many people living here. They had a protest actually a few weeks ago to highlight this increase in crime. Now, surprisingly, or maybe not surprisingly, on this social media site and other social media sites, this group is being, you guessed it, canceled. They're being referred to as an extremist group, a hate group. And I decided I wanted to get to the bottom of this, so I reached out to the organizer, one of the organizers, the spokesperson for the group, Adam Cooper. And I want to sit down with him and ask him directly about his group and get his side of the story. So I hope you'll enjoy this interview with Adam Cooper. All right, I'm joined by Adam Cooper. And for folks that don't know who Adam is, Adam, you've created quite the Facebook group here in Cambridge. First of all, tell me a little bit about this group, Neighborhood Watch, and it's getting quite a bit of attention, apparently.
Yes, it's a little surprising, a little overwhelming, but wonderful too. You know, we like to be able to get the word out. Basically, Neighborhood Watch is simply just a group of concerned citizens over Cambridge. We're over, well, almost at, I think, 10,500 people. And it's simply people that are just concerned about the crime that we have been seeing in Cambridge over the past 3 or 4 years. They're very much concerned about it, and we want to work to create awareness and basically come up with solutions that work not just for the group, but for everybody in the community.
So mostly people are posting pictures or incidents of crime, break and enters, anything that they've witnessed or experienced in the community.
Yes, exactly. We want people to be aware of what's going on. If there's, you know, crime that's active in one given area, then we let people know about that. People are not going to be helped if they don't know about what's going on. And it's about awareness, it's about community and letting everyone know what is happening and coming together as a community to say what can we do to stop this.
Now, unfortunately, your page has actually taken some negative attention. Maybe take me through some of that, what you've experienced, and then talk to me about why you think this is happening.
What we've experienced is basically we've had, well, what we the topic here is the cancel culture. We've had a lot of that occurring because some people basically have looked at some of our views on where the crime is coming from. I mean, you can't deny there was a problem with addiction related crime in Cambridge, and what many people do believe to be the some policies that are being pushed on us that are just simply making it worse and not helping the solution. We want solutions that actually work, and unfortunately, there's some people out there that instantly kind of have this this image created of who what anybody is like that would maybe oppose any of these policies, such as the policies that are going to the name of harm reduction, things that many people see in cities across the country that are, believe it or not, just simply not solving the problem. They could be making things worse. And some people, the second you speak up against it, or not against it, just have anything that's perceived as an opposing opinion, immediately want to put you in this box that they already have this preconceived idea of what someone that would even remotely seem to have any opposition to it is. You know, that you are these horrible monsters, you're against the homelessness, you're against drug addicts, which is just absolutely not true.
If you look at some of these posts, negative posts about Neighborhood Watch, you've been accused of being a vigilante group, extremist group, a hate group. So I'll ask you, is the Neighborhood Watch in Cambridge, is it a vigilante group?
Absolutely not.
Is it a extremist group?
Absolutely not.
Is it a hate group?
No.
Why do you perceive that your group now is being accused of some pretty terrible things then?
There's some people out there that feel that you know, they want to say, oh, you're homeless haters, or you're addict haters because of you know, we state that there's some policies out there that are making things worse, and because we say, well, we don't agree with that, think there's better ways to do it, then it's instantly labeled as, oh, well, you don't want to help the homeless, you don't want to help those suffering under the curse of addiction. And it's simply not true. It's, again, it comes down to this cancel culture that you have these days. We see some policies that are in play that we believe are not working, and we just want to offer other solutions, and their opinions are valid, and so are ours. It's just, unfortunately, some people instantly want to shut down opposing opinions. You know, we get the horrible things, you know, that are implications and accusations made against us, and myself being the spokesperson, that are just untrue. A lot of it is just plain absurd. It's a shame that it's happening. This is not an ideological argument to be won. This is a problem to be solved, okay? And we want some solutions that will work towards that. And some of the existing ones, and most of all, ones that are being aggressively pushed on this city and others, feel we're going to make things worse.
Do you fear that you've been unfairly targeted by this cancel culture?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, because it's they feel they have the moral high ground. They're not really looking at results or the decline of it's occurring in many cities, including Cambridge and others across the country. You cannot deny what is happening. It is happening. People are not imagining it. You're not suddenly getting a group of 10,000 people, which is, we're getting close to 10% of the population of 8% of the population of Cambridge. We're not going to have them suddenly get together and say, "Hey, let's be hateful." It's absurd. It doesn't happen. The very fact we're discussing it right now means there is a problem.
Do you feel that your side of the story, your side of the Neighborhood Watch group, has been depicted accurately?
Oh, absolutely not. Absolutely not. It's very quite shocking, the campaign that you can see online. And it's absolutely a classic case of cancel culture. What we are saying, the message we're sending, is simply of community awareness. This is people fighting and being very upset about their very feeling of safety in their homes, whether they feel safe walking down the street, whether they feel safe going to a park. And as long as people, the residents of this city, in any city, are going to feel in danger like that, if they feel their rights are being trampled on, they are going to object. You're going to see the outrage that we saw at the perfectly peaceful protest recently. You're going to see that, and as long as that occurs, the current situation is not sustainable.
Is this the start of the group, or do you feel that you're going to get more attention thrown at you, more negative attention? People might try to cancel this interview to try to cancel what you're trying to share here.
It's kind of expected. We see, you know, it's as you've seen, we discussed a little earlier, it's almost daily that we see these articles that are clearly and biased and just outright saying misinformation and making stuff up about us. I mean, they absolutely want to portray 8% of the population of this community as some kind of a hate group. And it started a fantastic discussion. We're going to keep going with it.
Do you worry about cancel culture, Adam, knowing that you can't have that opinion, that you can't share that crime is rising in certain areas and that people aren't allowed to post and to show what's happening to their sheds and their homes and their cars, and that those folks, yourself included, are going to be targeted because of your expressing those views?
I'm not too worried about it, because the fact is we do have... there's nothing wrong with what we're doing. There's nothing wrong with saying this happened to me last night. You know, I live on this street. Be aware of it. This is only going to expand. I know what we are doing. There's nothing wrong with it. We have all the good intentions. What is being said about us is just plain incorrect. I mean, if anybody wants to see what we're about and see what occurred at this protest, you keep hearing about this protest where I spoke at. I mean, if anybody wants to see for themselves what occurred, all they have to do is go onto YouTube and look up Take Back Cambridge. My entire speech is on there. Watch the whole thing. And I've said to some of these people that seem to be on this campaign to just cancel us and portray us as some horrible group, I've said, if what we're about and what I said was so horrible, why don't you share it? Why don't you share these videos of exactly what occurred that day? Put it out there.
Do you think that Cambridge, if not the entire political landscape, has become too polarized? You're either on this side or that side, and people can't meet in the middle to actually solve the problems at hand?
Yes. I mean, social media has a lot to do with that. Unfortunately, you get a lot of what's occurring here. We're starting to see a lot of conversation online about how this bickering and fighting, very much highlighted in the last month, since our protest. But it's actually been going on for a few years here. If everyone could just come together and realize that we all have the same goals, and there is no hatred here. I mean, who doesn't want to help the homeless? Who doesn't want to help people that are suffering under the curse of addiction? We all want to. But this cancel culture and this attitude of self-righteous virtue signaling, and just trying to just accusations of hate, unfounded accusations of hate, just grow. They grow like a cancer. And we end up in the situation we are right now, where people are fighting and nothing's being done.
Well, thanks so much, Adam. Really appreciate it to get your side of the story, the other side of the story. And hopefully, if anyone who's interested can check out the Neighborhood Watch group and have a look for themselves and see what Adam and many other people are posting on this site. Thanks so much, Adam. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Tyler. Appreciate it.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that intelligent and very articulate interview with Adam. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you'd like to see more videos like that, as we bring you the other side of the story here from Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. Thanks for watching.